Basics of solar panels. This video will show what a solar module is, differences between main types of solar modules, which solar modules are the most efficient ones, and what affects the energy output of a solar module. Photovoltaic or solar module is the main component of any solar electric system. A solar module consists of photovoltaic cells connected together. Photovoltaic cells and modules are made of semiconductor, usually silicon, which is capable to produce electricity when exposed to sunlight. Such an ability is called a photovoltaic effect. Photovoltaic modules generate DC electricity. They are produced in various type and size, and they have a lifetime of more than 25 years. Solar module is the main unit of any solar electric system. A solar module consists of solar cells connected together. To achieve higher energy yield, solar modules are connected in solar arrays. Here you see the main types of photovoltaic units, that is, solar cell, solar module, solar panel, and solar array. A solar electric system is the ultimate point of solar module application. It contains an installed solar array generating electricity from sunlight. A solar electric system can replace partially or completely your electricity provider, thus saving you money. A solar system can be connected to or disconnected from the utility grid. The generated electricity can be either used right away or stored in a battery for later use. Solar modules consist of photovoltaic cells connected in series and in parallel. Solar modules differ mostly in their type. They can be monocrystalline, polycrystalline, and thin film. They also differ in their power output, also known as power rating or rated power. Another point of difference is output voltage. It can be 12 volts, 24 volts, 48 volts or 60 volts. Solar modules also differ in their size and weight. There are three main types of solar modules: monocrystalline, polycrystalline, and thin film ones. We'll briefly give some info about each type. Monocrystalline modules are the most efficient but also the most expensive ones. They come in a blue or black color. You would probably ask what efficiency of a solar module is. Well, the less photovoltaic modules you need to produce a certain amount of power, the higher their efficiency. Normally, if there is not enough free space on your roof, you choose solar module with high efficiency. Polycrystalline modules are slightly less efficient and cost 30 to 50% less than monocrystalline ones when used to produce the same amount of power. Polycrystalline modules have a life cycle of about 25 years. Practice has shown, however, that polycrystalline modules installed more than 25 years ago are still perfectly operational. Polycrystalline modules are typically blue and can be easily distinguished by their multifaceted, kind of shimmering appearance. Thin film modules are the least expensive modules with the lowest efficiency. The efficiency of thin film modules is twice less than the efficiency of monocrystalline ones. This means that if you want to generate the same amount of power produced by monocrystalline modules, you need twice more thin film modules. Thin film modules have a dark surface, usually colored in brown, gray or black. Now it's important to precisely compare the three main types of solar modules by their efficiency. Monocrystalline and polycrystalline modules are the most commonly used ones in home and business solar electric systems. This table presents the area needed by every module type to produce 1 kilowatt of power. You can see that monocrystalline modules require the smallest area as they are the most efficient ones. Thin film modules require the largest area to install, therefore they are the least efficient ones. Now a very important question: what affects solar module output? The energy output of a solar module is affected by three main factors: location, orientation and tilt angle, and shading. Geographic location plays a really vital part in the energy output of any solar module. It determines the amount of solar radiation affecting directly the generated solar electricity. Solar radiation is evaluated in terms of perfects and hours, or PSH. PSH value can be obtained from solar maps. The value of perfects and hours for a specific location is not constant and varies throughout the year with every season. To learn more about how to determine the perfect sun hours, watch our video about solar maps included in the silver package. Orientation is the most important for energy output of a solar module. Optimal orientation might be different for summer and for winter. It should be noted that azimuth is much more critical than tilt angle. Certainly, the best performance is achieved when a solar module faces directly the sun. You can learn more practical tips in our silver package ebook. The third important factor critical for every solar module's energy output is shading. Shading is always detrimental for system performance. You should avoid shading whenever possible. It should be noted that thin film modules are less affected by shading. What is also important is that a site can be shaded in the morning and unshaded in the afternoon. It can also be unshaded in summer and shaded in winter when the sun is low in the sky and objects tend to cast longer shadows. SolarPanelsVenue.com. Adapting solar energy to your needs.